Welcome to my channel Glory with Mathematics. Please subscribe, like and share.
Dear students, in our last class we have discussed the number system, what you have learned in your earlier classes, like natural numbers, whole numbers, integers and rational numbers. So a question arises in our mind. Is there any number left after rational number in our number system or not? Yes, there are infinite number of numbers left after we are choosing rational numbers. What are those numbers? If we will take this box and let this is rational number. So, in rational number, whole number, natural number and integers are included in the rational number. So, if the whole set, whole box is our real number, then also there will be infinite number of numbers except rational numbers. And these numbers are known as irrational numbers. The numbers which are not rational are irrational. The numbers which are not rational, they are irrational numbers. Then which type of numbers are not rational? We know from the definition of a rational number that a number is a rational number if it can be represented in the form of p by q, where p and q both are integers and q is not equal to 0. So a number which cannot be expressed in the form of p by q, that is known as irrational number. So that means a number which cannot be expressed in the form of p by q, that is known as irrational number. So here we conclude that the rational numbers are different from irrational numbers. That means the number which are not rational are irrational number. So if we combine all the rational numbers with irrational number, then they form a set of numbers that is known as real numbers. So in a number line, each point is representing a real number, and or the real numbers are can be represented in a number line, and that number line is known as a real number line. So what is a real number line? And also you have to remember the real number is denoted by R. So every real number is represented by a unique point on the number line. Like natural number, integer and rational number, every real number can be represented by a unique point on a number line. Also, every point on the number line represents a unique real number. So, that number line is known as real number line. So, let us discuss how to represent some irrational numbers on a real number line. So some examples of irrational number. In your earlier classes, you already use the square root symbol. That means square root of 4 is equal to 2. Generally, we are taking the square root of 4 as positive integer. But the square root of 4 has minus 2 and plus 2. So here also, here we are taking only positive values. So first, Pythagorean proved that square root of 2 is irrational. So later it was proved that root 3, root 5, root 7, like all are, and pi was also pi is are irrational numbers. So we will prove this, how these numbers are known as or proved as irrational numbers, we shall discuss later, but here we shall now represent some irrational numbers on a real number line. Next example, locate root 2 on the number line. As I have told you, root 2 was first discovered by Pythagorean. So one question is there, how they have derived root 2? Perhaps they have derived in this way. So A, B, C, D is a square having side 1 unit. So by using Pythagoras theorem, the AC diagonal is 1 square plus 1 square, square root of, that is equal to square root of 2. So they might have discovered root 2 in this way. But here we have to represent root 2 on a number line. So here I have taken a number line. So this is 0, 1, 2 and towards left negative numbers are there. So we have to represent root 2. So this is 1 unit. So let this is O, this is A. So at point A, draw a perpendicular AB. By using your compass, draw a perpendicular AB at point A. So first step, draw BA perpendicular to the number line at point A. So here BA is equal to 1 unit. So this is a 1 unit and this is also 1 unit. Then second step, join OB. Then we have to join OB. So by using Pythagoras theorem, what is OB? OB is square root of AB square plus OA square. So this is equal to 1 plus 1. So this is equal to root 2 unit. So OB will be root 2 unit. So we got the length of OB is root 2 unit. But we have to represent root 2 on this number line. So by using your compass, taking O as center and OB as radius, draw an arc. So that will intersect the number line at a point like this. So if by taking O as center and OB as radius, if we will draw an arc, that is like this. So this arc will intersect the number line at a point. Let this point is C. So here third step is by using compass, taking O as center and OB as radius, draw an arc that will intersect number line at C. So as this is the circle, this is the arc of a circle, so OB will be equal to OC. So OC is equal to root 2 unit. So this is OC is equal to root 2 unit. So in this way we can represent root 2 on a number line. Next example, locate root 3 on the number line. So here the procedure is same as we have done for representation of root 2 on the number line, but one more step is here. So here I have drawn the number line. This is 0, 1, 2. So this is the distance of 1 unit. So let this is O and this is A. So the same step, first step is at point A, at A draw a perpendicular AB such that AB is 1 unit. So here I have to draw a perpendicular that AB is 1 unit. So this is 1 unit. Then second step, join OB. So we have proved in our previous example that OB is equal to root 2 unit by applying Pythagoras theorem. So OB is root 2 unit. So here to locate root 2 on the number line, we can use compass. By taking O as center and OB as radius, draw an arc like this that will intersect the number line at a point C, and then OC will be the root 2 unit. So by using compass, by taking O as center and OB as radius, draw an arc that will intersect the number line at C such that OC is equal to root 2 unit. Again, we will repeat the same procedure. At point C, draw a perpendicular line of 1 unit. So let this is D. So our fourth step is at C, draw DC perpendicular such that DC is equal to 1 unit. Then next step is join OD. Join OD. So now you consider the triangle OCD. In triangle OCD, so what is OD? OD square is equal to OC square plus CD square. So this is equal to root, OC is our root 2, so root 2 square plus 1. So this is equal to 3. So this implies OD is equal to root 3 unit. So here by taking, so our OD becomes root 3 unit. So by taking O as center, the same procedure what we have followed in the previous section. So that is taking O as center and OD as radius, draw an arc. So by taking O as center and OD as radius, draw an arc. So that will intersect the number line at, let this is at E. At E. So that OE is equal to root 3 unit. Or you can draw here also, as OB is root 2 unit, here also you can draw a perpendicular of 1 unit like this. So again you join this. So this will become also root 3 unit. Then we can draw the arc to represent it on the number line. Any procedure you can adopt to represent root 3 on a number line.